G'day folks, Ben from Snowy's here today showing you how to set up and pack away the 230 Yowie ABS hard shell rooftop tent. The Yowie's got a roomy ABS shell over the top that allows space for your bedding to be packed inside. It's got an X-frame design that makes for a smaller footprint suitable for setup on the back of a dual cab, yet it's really easy to set up when you get to campsite. So this is the Yowie ABS hard shell rooftop tent set up as it is here. Now this is a plastic ABS shell on top here, a bit of flex. You can't mount anything on top of this. It's just as it is. If you want something to mount, if you want to mount something on top of a rooftop tent, you probably need to look at a different version. But this weighs about 79 kilos, so it's pretty good in terms of how rooftop tent weights go. And it measures, they say about 150 centimeters, but I'd allow about 160 total in width and just over 130 in width this way. So, sorry, length is 150 to 160 and 130 this way. And it's about 35 centimeters in height to the sort of top here. So a little bit higher than a lot of rooftop tents, but the ladder's inside there. And there's also space down this end here to be able to fit a little bit of bedding. So a couple of sleeping bags or say a doona and a few pillows. The rooftop tent comes with accessories to mount it. Now, when you buy it, it's got rails mounted on the bottom here. Let's take the cap off of the end of these so you can see what the rails are like. So these are attached to the rooftop tent. There's one on each side here and there's 69 centimeters from center as well on this tent here it is anyway. So the tent is designed such that this is the back and obviously that's the front. So the vehicle is mounted in line with the tent this way and it folds out to the side of your vehicle. You can't really mount it the other way because of the design of the top here. I mean, you could, I suppose, but this isn't going to be very aerodynamic. Now mounting it that way means that your roof bars are actually going to run across this way, and you've got a few different options for doing that, but it comes with a heap of these bolts here, which has got the channel nut to fit inside that rail there, and you could actually just put that right through your roof rails there with one bolt if you like, if you had a hole that went all the way through. Alternatively, you can use two of them at each mounting point, and then you get four of these, and you can sandwich your roof rail in between. So if you can imagine, there's one here, your roof rail's running in between here, you can tighten that up so that it sandwiches your roof rail in there. So that would happen in four points on the tent. Now these are 69 centimeter centers from center to center for each of these and about 150 centimeters in length because they run pretty much the whole length of the tent. A lot of people question whether they can move it. I guess you potentially could, but you're gonna have to drill new holes in the bottom of your rooftop tent. I suggest maybe just leaving them where they are. I can't see why you would need to move these. If you're having to move them in, then the tent's not gonna be stable. If you're having to move them out, then you're probably increasing the stress in the middle of the tent there. Recommending you just leave them where they are. Onto the setup of the tent, there's four buckles holding these down into place. Now these are lockable. You get keys with these. I haven't got that locked at the moment, but you can actually lock that shut so you can't get this off. If it was locked, use your key and unlock it, lift this up, undo this cam buckle here to loosen it, and that comes off. That's just attached in a loop there, so you can't actually lose that at all. There's four of these, one this side, one that side, and there's also two on the back of the tent as well. Undo all of those, and then we're ready to pop it up. So that's just sitting loose on top there now. Now, we've just got this sitting on top of some pallets here. Now, there's actually gas struts in place to help lift this up, so there's not a lot of muscle to put it into place. So if this is on top of the tent, obviously you'd be pushing up, but I'll just push this up here now to show you that this just pops up into place. So get it started, it goes all the way. This is the strap we used to actually pack it up. That was sort of just tucked under there that time, but you're best actually throwing that in underneath here when you pack it up. But now that we've got the tent out, we can either just throw it over the top or just leave it hanging down if you like. And before we go any further, just make sure that's all the way up. You've got this elastic strap here. Now this is just here to pull all this fabric in. We pull this down and there's little locating hooks down here just to hook that around. There's one of them on each side just to keep that down and out the way. We don't need that again until we pack it up. From here, we actually reach in and grab the ladder. So you can see the ladder is actually part of this. Oh, it's actually incorporated in here. It's all part of the setup. I'm going to need to put my foot against the edge here because this isn't actually mounted to the pallet here to stop it sliding. But I pull this and the tent folds out. Keep coming all the way. And at this stage, the inner bit kind of folds in out from this top section here, or in from underneath this top section here. These boot pockets here, just make sure they hang down. And then the ladder, in the instance where this would be set up high, this is a 2.3 meter ladder, we'd undo this and then you can stretch this ladder out. So it goes out to 2.3 meters. This actually needs to sit at about sort of a 70 degree angle and forms part of the structure of this side of the tent. So it actually supports this end of the tent here. Before I go any further, I just want to point out something we've noticed when we packed this up and unpacked it. And I'll just push this up a little bit again, and it refers to this rubber sort of stop here, which supports the frame or stops the frame from hitting this, just gives it support. There are instances where we've found this fabric can get caught up in there. So as you pack it up and unpack it and all this fabric unfurls, just make sure that this is clear of this so you're not getting it caught up or stressing it. Probably the main thing to note is as you're packing it up or undoing, if anything feels like it's getting caught, you shouldn't have to force it. It all sits into place just nicely. If something feels like it's not moving like it should, maybe just stop and make sure no fabric's caught up. So next step for us is to extend this frame out. So we just push this up, and before we push it too far, we're just gonna come around to the side here and make sure that this is all attached around the end. So we've got this Velcro strip down here that we want to attach this to. It goes around the pole like this, and then there's a strap at the base here where this just loops in here, and that just stops that from flapping around too much. So we need to undo that again for pack up. We do the same thing on the other side. Once we've got them done up, we can stretch this out as far as it will comfortably go. And then there's locking triggers on here just to keep that from collapsing back down there on each side. Now the awnings on the side, we've got a few setup options. At the moment it's hanging down loose, but you can actually roll these up and use these four tabs, one, two, and two on the other side with the loops underneath here to just secure it like this up and out the way if you want. Alternatively, if you want to just leave it down flat and don't want it to flap around too much, there are these tabs here that you can just put through the eyelets there. You've got one here, one at this end here as well. So you can just fold the gussets in underneath and keep that flat against the tent. But probably the way most people will set it up, and it's just as quick to do that, is to use these flexible poles here. You get four of these with the tent, so two for each awning on each side of the tent, and they line up with these holes here that are on the side of the tent, one at the front there behind the fabric, and then this one here that's not hidden behind the fabric is right out for you to see. Push that into the hole with this bit pointing downwards and flex it up, then grab the awning. The eyelet goes over the top of the loop there and just holds that in place. So that just stays in place under the tension of the flexed pole. Second one goes in here over the eyelet, and that's all set up. And that then creates a weatherproof awning. So even if it is really rainy or sunny, you've got shade and you've got wind protection. You can do the same thing on the other side. This adds about an extra 60 centimeters of space. That is the 230 Yowie ABS hard shell rooftop tent all set up. Now pack up for this is really easy, pretty much everything in reverse. First thing we'd want to do is take these awnings down on each side here. So take the poles out, and obviously same thing on the other side, and you can just leave them sitting loose if you like. There's a strap that will, the elastic strap will sort of pull all that in. Maybe don't leave it rolled up because the rolled fabric can create a bit more bulk when you try and pack it up. Now, to pack this up, I want to throw some bedding inside to show you how it packs up with bedding in there. Now, I have tried it with a couple of sleeping bags like this rolled up at the back of the tent. Now, this is limiting because what happens is the bottom half of the rooftop tent comes up and it folds and it hits this and you can't get it all the way down. So I've got just a soft sleeping bag here. This is quite bulky. It's just a single. I'm just going to put this in one half of the tent, sort of bulk it up so that as the tent folds up, this has got a bit of a give to sort of squash it down. So I'll take this inside the tent and tuck it up where I show you need to put it for your bedding inside. So we'll throw this right at the end here. Now, I haven't actually tried this with the bedding inside, but it's at this end here where you've got space for the bedding. So I tuck it up there. If you had a couple of pillows or something, it's obviously going to fit pretty comfortably in there, but push it as far up as you can because you just need to allow space for this half of the tent to fold up and come down in front of this. So push it all up there. You can see that's a single sleeping bag there. You could jam another one in there. We'll see how it folds up with that inside, give you a good idea on how much bedding you can put in here. Now, next step for pack up is to make sure that the fly sheet is detached from these poles at the front here. So we've got a loop here that we need to undo. There's a strap down here that we can undo or just loosen if you like. And then this Velcro strip here, we need to loosen that completely. We do that on each side, and then we can use the quick release triggers. We'll release these locking triggers on this frame around this end here, and this frame will collapse down. But before I do that, what I'm gonna do is just close this door at the front here. If we have the fabric nice and flat when we fold it, it's much easier. The fabric tends to fold better in the tent than when it's sort of rolled up like a sausage. Not essential, but just makes things just a little bit easier. So now we tap this just to get that to collapse down. And from here, we need to use the ladder to fold it all up. These will fold up inside. Just make sure they're empty when you do it. And to fold it up, we just push this inside like that. So it sort of folds in on itself. Keep pushing, make sure the fabric's tucked up. Keep this outside, this is to pull the top down. And that pushes right inside the tent. And this is where we hope we've got enough space with the bedding. Now at this point, you can't get to the bedding to tuck it in, so that's why it's important to make sure you've got it all pushed up to the back of the tent there. So that doesn't quite feel like it's sitting flat, but we'll see if the top goes down anyway. But before we do that, we grab our elastic strap around the bottom here and put that up over the top. That then just pulls all of that fabric in. And that's just making sure it all sits within inside the ABS shell. If this was on top of a vehicle, obviously you'd be able to pull this. This is how you'd reach the top of it, but we've got it set down nice and low here so I can actually reach the top. And I'm certainly not having to put a lot of muscle into closing that down. That went, or shut down pretty easily, much easier than a lot of rooftop tents that I've set up before. Now, this strap just does up in here, so I just need to push down a little bit further. Sits in there like that. This goes down over the top and we can use a key to tighten that. These can then be further tightened. It's a bit of a cam lock in there, so you can actually tighten them down further. And there's four of these straps around the end. So there's one there, one on this side here. So we've got two straps here at the back as well, which is on the hinge side of the tent. Same deal, hooks in like that. And we can tighten it down with this ratchet strap here or this cam buckle here. That's the 230 Yowie rooftop tent. Pack up of that's really easy. I've got a sleeping bag packed in here and it's still folded up nice and easily. You could put a second sleeping bag in there, or even just a lightweight sleeping bag or a doona, and a couple of pillows are gonna pack in there pretty easily. You can check these out online at snowies.com.au where you find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information. And check out some other awesome 230 products like these ones down here.